Rev up your engines. Today I'm going to answer the question, should you buy a car from CarGurus? Now CarGurus is a Cambridge, Massachusetts based company that does research to find where you can buy a car. They have algorithms that compare the prices, the dealers. When you're looking for a car, it gives you what's called an instant market value of what you're looking for, then compares them all over the place. Now the company itself, CarGurus, gets paid $15 by a car lot, by a dealership. Whether they buy it or not is immaterial. They get their 15 bucks if they can swerve you to go to them. They get their 15 bucks just because you looked it up on their site and then you contacted a particular dealer. So they're making a $15 profit, even if anything's not bought. And let's say you're not a car dealer. Well, for non-car dealers, CarGurus will let you list the car for free. But if it's sold, the seller of the car pays CarGuru $99 for the service. Now CarGurus themselves says nobody pays them to put it in a particular order like one company's paying them more money to be at the top of the list. They say it's based on the price and what you're looking for in your area. Last time I checked, they had more than 3 million used cars for sale and over 450,000 new cars listed on CarGurus. Now CarGurus was founded in 2006 by Mr. Steiner. He was one of the co-founders of TripAdvisor. You go to something like TripAdvisor, you're only going to stay at a place for a few days, maybe a week or something. If things aren't perfect, well, it's not going to end the world. But if you're using a system like that to buy a car that you're going to be driving for years, sight unseen, I'd be kind of leery about that myself. Now, locally here in Houston, a big city, they're advertising the heck out of them. I see their ads all over the place. So obviously they're putting a lot of money in this thing. So they are making money to even pay for all these advertisements. Now in the year 2017, CarGurus went from being a public company to being traded on the stock market. And as of today, at least, it's got a $3.95 billion market cap. So it's a large corporation. And as with any large corporation, a lot of times they get away from the original idea and they start thinking, how can we make a profit? And then often, there's very little correlation between what they're trying to get you to buy and whether it's any good or not. Now, theoretically, the listings are fair. Nobody's paying to be at the top of the list. Say it's a car dealership. They say that, well, if the dealerships get good ratings, then they go higher up on the list. And if you know anything about ratings on the internet, those things can be faked so easily. You go to Amazon, there's a new product, you see all these great ratings, and then you look and they're almost all written the same and often in bad English. Then you know, hey, there's a Chinese company out there that's trying to sell this stuff. I've checked those things out over the years and found that quite a few of them, which I actually tested out myself, were garbage products, and then later they weren't even be sold on Amazon because they checked and found out real people ended up saying, hey, these are horrible products, and so they went off the list. I don't trust ratings on the internet one iota. They're probably listing it mainly by the price, right? They have no idea what kind of shape these cars are in. So if a guy's got a later model car, it'll probably make it higher on their list. Maybe the car was wrecked, flooded, stolen. Who knows? You don't have any idea about that. And CarGurus can even allow financing themselves because, of course, as I said, they're a huge corporation. They see, hey, they want to get in the financing game because there's so much profit out of that stuff. You got a $100,000 CD and you're making like 0.5% interest. These guys are out there with these used cars. Their interest rates are sky high. They're making a fortune if they're loaning you money. Now, the way it's set up is kind of squirrely, too. Because let's say you pick a car you want. You're allowed to give your email or phone number to CarGurus, who contacts the dealer. A lot of people have said, hey, the dealer never contacted me back. Now, of course, CarGuru doesn't want to show you exactly where it is because then you could just say, well, the heck with them. I'll just go to the dealer myself and buy it. Then they don't get their dollars for sending you over there. So it's all done on the internet, and we all know things can screw up on that all the time. Lots of people, including some of my customers, who were going to try it. When I went to the dealer, they were told, oh, that one's already been sold. Here's something else we got for sale. The used car business is kind of dirty. Everybody who's ever been involved in it knows that. They've always got lost leaders to try to get you in. They'll say, well, we only had one at that price, but here's some more here. And they're just doing it to get you to come in, thinking that they'll be able to sell you something now that they got you in person. Now, as I've always said, you can often get the best deal from private individuals. There are some private individuals on CarGuru, but mainly it's car dealers. It's rare that you're ever going to get a good deal from a car dealer. They're pros. If they buy a car for $3,000, they want to sell it for $6,000 or $9,000. And to top it off, there's certain fees and stuff that aren't included in the price at the show. Both CarGuru and the dealers do not have to stand by that original price. They've got disclaimers all over the place, their corporation. But they say any price does not have to be honored by CarGurus or the dealership. They're covering their own heinies. So if you go there and the price is different, or they don't have that car, you can't sue them or anything. They're a corporation, you know. You need a lawyer to read through half of those contracts. And these extra fees can go as high as $1,300. And I'm telling you that stuff until it's too late. And when it comes to the title of the car, hey, you buy a car, you want the title in hand. I've done some research, and a lot of people have complained that they bought a car from them, took them forever to get the title. Some of them haven't even gotten it yet. You deal with a giant bureaucratic corporation like CarGurus with $3.95 billion valuation, things are going to screw up. That's just how it goes in today's world. Like I've always said, if you're buying a used car, you want to see the title in hand, because you want to flip it over. And if it says reconditioned or salvage title, you don't even want to buy the thing. If you don't have that information at hand, me, I wouldn't touch a car. All a seller has to do to put it on CarGurus is have the car year, the vehicle identification number, the transmission type, the color, and a photo. Photos often lie. You can Photoshop, or even more obvious, let's say the back of the car smashed in. Take a picture of the front of the car. Or, in the case of something that happened to me once, I got a truck from an auction site. It was a Toyota truck. I figured, ha, gotta be a great truck, no problems, you know. Show the top of it, looked clean, paint was good. When I got under that truck, the frames were all rotten away. They, of course, didn't show a picture of that on the side. They showed where the paint was shiny and everything. Buying a car without seeing it and road testing it is just plain dumb. So as far as I'm concerned, it's a gigantic corporation that spends a fortune advertising what a great job they do. What do they know about the cars they're listing on their site? Hundreds of thousands of them. 3 million used cars and 450,000 new cars the last time I checked. Basically, you got this giant corporation that's bird dogging for people who are selling used cars. They're a go-between. They really don't know that much about the car that's being sold. Me, I'd stay far away from things like that. They got them listed from best ones to worst, but how are they saying which one is best? They really don't know anything about these cars. They're going by hearsay of what, oh, who rated this company, who rated this better or not. Who's to say that people that work at those companies aren't just typing in things saying, oh yeah, this dealer's great, oh fantastic. I know a guy who ran a shop, and that's what he did when his mechanics weren't working. He'd go on social media, and he'd have his mechanics, when they weren't busy, typing around saying how great his garage was. So me, I wouldn't waste my time with CarGurus if I was looking for a car. There's just too many ifs. They just make it look convenient. Come on now, buying used cars is a lot more complex than that if you want to do it right. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.